the outset, I was with our president yesterday and informed him that today would be the closing ceremonies of the Balikatan, and he extends his congratulations to both armed forces and all those who participated for the successful conduct of this year's exercise. And he looks forward to next year's exercise, which will be the, I believe, the full battle simulation, which will put to the test the combined capabilities in the most realistic of scenarios possible, with safety in mind. And after this exercise, both sides will go back to the drawing board. The President, no less, is waiting for an extensive debrief of our successes, but more so of our gaps and what we need to fill in capabilities, in interoperability, in human resource capabilities too, and in sustainment, which is extremely important for the continuation of bilateral and multilateral cooperation going forward. And I have told the armed forces of the Philippines that we will be increasing the pressure continuously for them to evolve as soon as possible into a multi-threat, multi-theater operating armed force consistent with the archipelagic doctrine nature of our country and the necessity for defending it in a proactive and not a passive manner. In the same vein, exercises such as this should be continued because for us men who are consigned to the kitchen at home, we know the worst thing in a kitchen is a dull knife. And a good chef hones the knife every day. This is what we should do, and this is what we are going to do. Singularly, bilaterally, and multilaterally. This is the way like-minded nations in this part of the world, in the Indo-Pacific, should go. And no amount of malign, or for lack of a better term, perverse attempts to subvert our goal for a free and open Indo-Pacific and a rules-based international order will stop our shared advance towards upholding these internationally accepted norms, come what may. So I congratulate not only those who participated, but the government of the United States, government of Australia, the government of France. We welcome more multilateral cooperative activities and maritime cooperative activities. We thank our civilian partners, the Coast Guard and the Philippine National Police, whose assistance was vital. And we thank the local communities who will continue to welcome us because our national pride, territorial integrity and dignity are non-negotiables for each and every Filipino.